guys, Brayden here, and welcome back to City Skylines in Vanguard. And today, we are doing a big project. Now, generally speaking, when I do these big projects, they're sort of done in the time lapses at the start of the video, and then we do some other general stuff throughout the actual live part of the video. But I wanted to do at least one project throughout the series. I'll probably do these every now and then in the actual live video. So in the time lapse, well, you're watching that now, so you pretty much know what's going on. You saw some of the cinematic shots of the finished product, so that's a sneak peek of the actual project that we're doing live. I say live, it's not live actually, it's delayed. This was recorded like a week ago and I just haven't gotten around to editing it. But yeah, we're basically building sort of a new university little park sort of thing, and there's some nice cool buildings. It's like a little complex of sort of an entertainment university park. I don't really know what it is, like a tech park maybe you could call it. Not really though, I don't know. It's just sort of a nice little place for people to gather. There's what looks like an event center, some cool office buildings, and the university, as I said. And it's just a cool little area. There's lots of sort of decorations using the new prop line tool, laying out rocks and trees, making it look all pretty. And that's basically what you don't really get to see when I do stuff in the time lapses. You don't get to see sort of the work and the decision-making process, if there is any, that actually goes into making these big projects. And it actually turns out really good. I'm kind of happy. There's a couple of extra things I want to do, which I'll do in between episodes, obviously. But for the most part, it actually looks really good. I'm quite happy with it. So I will let you watch the time lapse, and I will see you in the video.
I'm running you before the memory's gone.
So as it usually goes in between episodes, I went and downloaded more assets because the 500 odd I had already was not enough. It was pretty much exclusively like trees and bushes and stuff, as you can see here. I've basically gone through and redone a lot of the decorations through the city just because I didn't really have enough variety and didn't really look realistic enough. So I don't know why there's a fence missing there either. There's like fences up to there and they've just buggered off elsewhere. Which is interesting. But yeah, all the decorations have been redone. They're a lot thicker. I haven't put fences in. Where do my... Okay, I know that I sort of lost some of the save stuff, but I definitely did this. So that's kind of irritating. If I could, like, pause that so everything would stop. I did get the prop line tool as well. That's another thing I downloaded, which is a different version of the prop line... Or draw prop... I don't know what that's actually called. It's called the barrier placer or something, I think. But the prop line tool basically allows you to actually go into your props, select any of these props, in this case this riding stable short fence, go over here to the line thing, I'm going to turn on fence mode, and then I can... Oh wait, I need to turn on anarchy for it, don't I? Because if you go into PLT anarchy on, there we go, and then I should be able to just place all of these. Like, okay, well, oh, I should probably put shift P. Yes, yes, yes. Also, we can undo it, which is kind of awesome. Whether or not that works now, it was working before. Okay, now it's working. They are a little bit wonky sometimes. You can't really notice it when you're looking at it like that. I'm not sure if there's a way to fix that, but it will do for now. It certainly saves me a lot of time going and individually drawing fences and stuff. I might come back and redo them once I figure out exactly how to use it properly. But as you can see, placing fences is a hell of a lot easier than it was before. There you go. Fence is done. Beautiful. Okay. If I could not sort of get thrown up on the buildings, that'd be great. I went through and downloaded a bunch of grass. I got my old flowers back. I got some, like, palm trees and banana leaf things and some yucca plants and so on and so forth. And some, like, colourful bushes and things. And some new trees. And basically just went through and sort of redid the decorations and they look kind of nice. I still haven't decorated all this. I don't really know what I want to do down here. So, yeah, I want to turn this into a little garden area as well. I've been losing a little bit of inspiration for City Skylines lately. I mean, I have played 500 hours of it. But I'm just finding it difficult to get into it and, like, keep building stuff, which is not a good thing. But I'm going to try and get that back by building something awesome today. So what I'm going to do is... Oh, education, just on the idea, because that's what we're going to be building, is a university thing. These are elementary schools, and they're really good to put in the city, because the other ones are sort of really low density and they don't fit very well anywhere. And these things, they're high schools. Which are kind of awesome, and I love how they sort of overhang. Oh my god, it's so slow. I'm not going to bother going down to street level. I can change the speed of that, though. Movement speed, 23. And then I can just jump down here and see how cool that looks. Look at that. It's kind of cool. So that'll hopefully get our education back under control. Also, what I'm going to do is... oh, hang on. I just need to... Because I tried recording this episode once before, so I know how everything's going to be laid out. So, what I'm gonna do is draw that up to there. Get rid of you. Go into... I think it's the sixth one. Oh, what's this? Oh, that's a cool building. Oh, that's very large. Okay. I'm gonna have a whole bunch of these buildings over in this area. It's not gonna be as dense as this. It's gonna be a lot of sort of... just pockets of actual buildings and then a bunch of sort of placed things. So there's not actually going to be a real lot of people over here. And then lots of parks and sort of thing in between. Right, where is the thing I am looking for? I think it is right down the... this thing. Yes, because this sort of looks like a convention center to me. I don't know what it actually is, but it looks like a convention center to me. Is there anywhere I can get the actual light on it? There we go. Beautiful. Like that. It is Walker and Hayes. I don't know what Walker and Hayes is. This is like the third time I've tried recording this. And it's the third time I've said I don't know what Walker and Hayes is, and I still haven't looked it up. So that's what you're all for. You can tell me what that is. Also, it says Enzo. Look, it's got a bunch of different things on the side. So maybe it is a convention center of some description. But it looks kind of cool. Let's go back to the middle of the day. Also, I've been using a different LUT. I've been using the Corn William one because I think it looks a lot nicer. It's got a very stylized sort of look. I don't know, your mileage may vary. I can't really find an LUT that I like that much. Which is kind of annoying, but I'll find one eventually. What I want to do is, because... And I know this now because a billion people have told me that the reason people slow down when coming up these roads and slow down when they're coming up to, like, intersections around these things coming onto the freeway is because this intersection and where the road was before... are too close to each other, and that sort of freaks out the traffic AI. So, I don't know why that's raised up. Can you not be raised up? Also, that's raised up, and I don't know why. But whatever. Why is that? Okay, well, I'm probably going to bite us in the ass later. But also, that's not far enough. It's supposed to go there. Okay, there we go. So if we go here, we go 5 units. 5 units and 150 degrees from memory. Hang on. Got to get rid of this. If I can just sort of chuck you down that way. Join you up to that. Get rid of that. And then... Oh, God, I'm going to have to do the train lines as well. Everything's so difficult for me. Why is it always so difficult? How many units is that up to there? That's 22 units, so we want to go 11, and we want to go 6 high, not 12. There we go. And then oh god, itchy back. Jesus Christ. If I go in line with that, and grab that there, then that's... Yeah, it's fine. I still need to make this a concrete bit in the middle. Why is my back so itchy? Stop being itchy. This is not the goddamn time. Be itchy some other time. Okay. I don't know what these cars... Oh, right. The rubber's gone through there before. Okay. Got ya. There we go. Right. So, if I just link that up to there and then bring that across there. Yes. That should actually work. And then, because I've moved this up a little bit further... That should hopefully go like that. Make sure that there's enough space. And that's actually kind of a cool looking little intersection. There's some cool curvy roads. There we go. Nice. All right. I'm just thinking. If I make this come out like that. Is that going to work better? That probably is going to work better, hey? I might move this road a little bit. Wait, how many was that? That's not... Okay, no, that's perfect anyway. So, there we go. That'll do. There we go. I kind of like how that looks. It's interesting. Also, I didn't show off what I did in between episodes, did I? I mean, you've seen it in the time-lapse, but I did this thing. Lots of modifications to this area, including... These weren't actually done in the time-lapse, but these were done after when I downloaded some stuff. And basically, the only place that these guys are linked up... This one isn't linked up at all except to this. But basically, this is linked up to our cargo area, so they can come through down under here, and those guys will all pop out right there. There they are. But this will be linked up properly in a little bit. I'll also fix this area up. So this used to be a roundabout as the entrance to the city, and there used to be an interchange about here, but that was sort of pointless. So now we just have the interchange back here for people to get on, and then they sort of split off into two directions to either go into this part of the city or this part of the city or over here, whichever way they want to go. Also, there's this, which is kind of interesting. So that's the thing. And yeah, I think that's it. Oh, yeah, this place is kind of cool. Also not joined up with power. I don't know why it's not joined up with power. Hang on, where's my concrete pieces? Because concrete pieces can carry power across places. Come on. Oh my god, I don't realize how many assets and parks and shit I have until you go trying to scroll through them. Okay, well. That'll join up in a second. Hang on. Right, so if we grab one of our single unit roads and we grab it and drag it up this way, that's going to be exactly where I want it to be. And then if I grab, well, not four, like that. Like that. And then I download these other cool things. These guys, like that. They look really cool. Sort of like dippy water things. They remind me of sort of like Trials Fusion or Anno or something. Actually, they may be from Anno. One of my, this thing is from Anno as well. Someone told me. So there you go. It's kind of cool. There is a park that I wanted to use. I'm not sure which one I wanted to use though. Oh, I didn't get rid of the... Did I get rid of the props for this? Oh, shit it. I didn't. Damn, that's not good. Okay, well, damn. I wanted to get rid of the little arrow things because they go the wrong way, and I wanted to use this as a decoration in here. But it's not really going to work now. We'll see if I can make it work, though. Anywho, where's the park that I wanted to use? It should be. I don't know if it was this one. It looks cool. Or was it the plaza? I don't know how the plaza looks because I downloaded a new plaza. Oh, that's this thing. Oh, that's too big. Okay, damn. This thing. Oh, it's too small. Damn it. Okay, well. The... I think it's called Falling Pillars? Well, I've gone past it, haven't I? You idiot, Raiden. Where is it? Okay, there it is. I don't know why I can't see it. It just seems to be difficult to see. Alright, that's like that. There we go. Beautiful. And then... Now, the difficult part here is getting every bloody thing to line up. Because... It's a bit of a shithead. Hang on. Come out here. No. Like that. That should be lined up, yeah? It better bloody be lined up. Where's me universe? What is that? Elementary. Oh, I downloaded another elementary school, did I? Okay, that's cool. Oh, I downloaded another hospital as well. I downloaded this thing! It's kind of spiffy looking. I like it. It's more like a... I don't know what it is. It's more like a clinic, really. Like, just a big clinic than a hospital, but... It's kind of cool. I like it. I suppose it is more a clinic. Does it actually say that it's a clinic? Wait, are you... Health center. Well, sure. Right, education. I got a really cool looking, if I could find it, university. Which is the same style as these things, as you can see. So they're all part of the same pack. It's kind of cool. Gives it a nice little uniform feel. That can line up there. Be all symmetrical. And then you can join up over there. Like so. Beautiful. Alright. Now, I think, because we had a... Make sure this has power now. There you go. Beautiful. There used to be a subway station there. We're going to put this in here. I'm going to have to delete you, though. Oh, we probably don't even need it there then, do we? Because we have this one, like, right here. Nah, we'll have one going right to the university just for shits and giggles. It's completely pointless, but I don't care. Right, so you can jump out this way. You can jump out there. There we go. It's been a while since I've made one of these. Well, actually, it hasn't, because, like I said, I've tried to record this twice, and just didn't work out, which is far... What have I done? Oh, for God's sake. Okay, well, I'll just redo those lines in a bit. The purple ones, you can die. And you can die. There we go. Beautiful. Alright. Oh, yeah, I also redid these decorations, so there's some nice flowers on the ground and everything. It's kind of cool. I like it. I tried to disguise this concrete thing going through there. I don't know what the hell that is. I can't delete it. It's not like any of this, so I don't know where the hell it's come from or what it is. But apparently it's there now, so there you go. Anywho, back to this one. Actually, let's go to the Corn William filter. I like the Corn William filter. Yeah, that's nice. That's very nice. I think it suits the feel of the city more. I don't know. Also, I accidentally turned my settings down because I was going to try and make the frame rate run better, but then it crashed, and I thought, nah, the frame rate's good enough. So when I came back and rebooted it after it was crashed, it still had actually changed the settings, even though it crashed the goddamn game. So now I'm running on medium settings. So if it looks like ass, that's why I don't think it really makes that much of a difference. The game's not that good looking anyway, but it's okay. It's what you build that makes it pretty. Isn't that right? Now, there is a building that I know, because I was experimenting before. This is about where I got up to in the recording, but I know there's a building that fits along here. I don't know what it is or where it is. This one. So that one. Big office building. That sounds familiar. See, but that should... I can't really measure it properly, because there's no roads that face the right way. Oh, there's that one. What? No, okay, that's not going to work. But that should... See, if you measure it with your fingers now, that's going to fit along there. So, if I... And this is, this is why I wanted the roundabout thingy. Because I wanted to have a little roundabout here. But it doesn't seem like it's going to work out for me. But if I go... And I grab a little one-cell-wide thingamabobber. No, don't snap. Don't be a shithead. There you go. I want you to go straight... Command A. No. Nope. Okay, you're not going to go straight, apparently. Come on, straight. Okay, fine. No, it's just okay. There. No, it's cool. It's cool. It's cool. But that should fit there. It does. Oh, yeah. There's not really any space left on the walkway along here now. But I don't care. There we go. That's, but you can walk through. You can walk through this little tiny bit in there. Okay, that's cool. I like it. It's a very, very nice looking building. Oh, look at that. That's pretty. That's lovely. Jesus Christ, okay. Those ones then. Beautiful, done. All right. there's a funny comment on the last video as well. It's like, really love your city, but Jesus, you're annoying. Oh, which made me laugh. So, to that person, glad you're enjoying the videos. And you're welcome for my annoyingness. I enjoy comments like that. They're funny. Make this concrete, I think. See, the thing with me is I'm a bit of an arrogant prick, to be honest. And I get a kick out of knowing I annoy people or piss people off. And a lot of the time I do it deliberately. So, you know, that kind of makes me happy if I see that. But it wasn't done in a nasty way. And I appreciate it when people, even if they're saying things that mightn't be the nicest, when they say it in a respectful and not just straight up dickheadish way. So thank you to that person for voicing your opinion. I agree. A lot of the time I am annoying. So there you go. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you handle... Well, I mean, you could call it a hate comment. It's not really a hate comment, is it? It's just a someone's voicing their opinion about you comment, which I have absolutely zero problem with. I mean, I don't really care what people comment. They can comment here saying horrible, horrible, horrible things. It doesn't bother me. One of those people who just doesn't give a shit what other people think. Which a lot of the time isn't a good thing, but when it comes to life in general, there's going to be not particularly nice people saying not very nice things about you. And it's a good thing when you... have just learned not to give a shit. It's not so much learned, I just never have. But, some people are more sensitive about that, which is... sucks to be. No, it's fine. Put a little fence up against the hedge. There we go. Like that fence. I wish I could find... Because my favorite fence in the game... Actually, probably my favorite asset in the game is, like, that fence. I just love that for some reason. I used it in the last city, and I love it to death. And I need to find the asset. I don't know where it is. Right now, I'm using these cottage fences, and they don't really fit the city perfectly. I mean, they sort of fit it because they're a fence still, but... Eh, I don't know. Anywho, I don't know why I'm saying anywho today. That's a stupid thing to say. Don't say it, freaking Jesus. If I can grab my... these things, and sort of put them not like that, I should actually be able to get that road fitting around inside that. Do you reckon? I reckon I could probably do it. That sounds like a challenge to me. I want to turn you and put you back where you were. No, I need to turn you back a little bit. Yeah, like that. Yes. There we go. And then I can move this road up to... I'm going to have to do this all by hand, aren't I? Yes, you bloody well bet I am. No, lock. Come on. No, 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 no. Three. Nope, okay. Well, this is... I'm... this isn't going to work, is it? Two, three. Ooh, there we go. There we go. Hello. Just till it hits three. There we go. And then, no, bugger off. Bugger off. Not in the mood for your shit, bro. There we go. There we are. All right. This is going to be the most wonky ass bloody thing. I don't even know why I'm doing it because I know already that I'm not going to keep it, but. Raggedy ass looking thing. No, I won't have that. Are there any other little ornaments I could chuck in the middle, I wonder? Oh, what the hell was that noise? That's my mouth? Yeah. Sound weird. It's not much that would look good in the middle. I mean, there's this thing, obviously, we already have one. It's just difficult to place them. No, you're too big. And also useless. There's that. No, that's massive. I just need more little things like that. There's a fountain. Oh, hello. What do you look like? What the hell is that? Is that supposed to be shooting water? That looks so stupid. Why would anyone ever use that? I think I've said before about that, actually. What do they do for the water in these things? They just don't have water. There's no actual, like, water fountains. It's kind of annoying. No, there's nothing really there. We're just going to have to go with a straight road, I think. Don't really want to, but I don't really have a choice. There's not much else I can do. All right, that's cool. And let me just go there. Hey, ooh, okay, screwed stuff up on this side. Actually, I think I want this to be concrete. Hang on, let me just chuck a pedestrian path there, like say, and then I'm gonna grab my favorite fences, my best friend in this game. Where are you? Come here, my friend. Love me. There you are. And then I'm gonna frame this area with the fences. There we go. And there we go. Beautiful. And there we go. Oh, it's so tedious doing this stuff. I remember doing the farm that I did in the last series. That was just hell. Just total hell. I didn't enjoy doing it, but I enjoyed the finished product. And that's the thing with City Skylines. A lot of the time it's tedious as shit to do, but you do it just because of that feeling that you know you're going to get at the end. Assuming you do it properly. If you don't do it properly, then you just think, oh my god, I've just wasted 2 hours of my life doing this. And that's a feeling that I've... I probably had that feeling more than I've had the other feeling, but... Yeah. It's like an addiction. It's a drug. Which is a drug. City Skylines is addictive. Can that... Hang on. I don't think there's actually any way to get these, like, properly straight. That's a feeling I have... in my bones. What? Don't do that shit. No, just... Why are you raised up there? Why? Can I... No, that's just raised up there, apparently, for whatever reason. Okay. Fine, you can stay raised up. I don't know why the hell it would be. It seems a little bit silly to me, and also I can't join that up. How crooked have I placed that, then? I'm thinking very... Where is that? Yeah, that should work. Eh. And we're going to go... There. There we go. Beautiful. Alright, and some whopping big rocks in the middle should do a nice job. Oh, also, I changed the building over here. It's no longer the Spinnaker Tower. It's not going to be this forever. I still need to basically... I think I'm going to delete everything in this block and just do a massive decorative park in there with, like, spirally spirals and shit. Because with the prop line tool, I can basically go to a tree and I can, like, select something real colourful. Where's a bush? Where's my colourful bushes? Like this one. And then I can do, like, just awesome shit like that. Look at that. Look at this. It's so cool. I can do, like, curves and shit. So that's something I'ma do for shizzle. And it'll be fun. Well, it won't be fun for me to do, but it'll be cool to look at in the end. Right, so, are they going to fit in here? They do just... Oh, wow, they actually do. Brilliant. All right. Works for me. And now we get to put my new decorations to the test. We're going to go single, because I want to place them by hand. There we go. We don't get much of the yellow color. I found that yellow seems to be really muted with the Corn William filter. Actually, all, like, sort of bright, vibrant colors seem to be muted. Like, see how muted that blue is? It's like a full-on sky blue. I want violet. There we go. See, the violet's actually kind of light normally. This one makes it sort of like a maroney colour. I mean, I don't mind it really, but you know, it's just something I pointed out. So that can go in here. We'll use a couple of these little spiky palm leaf tropical plant things. That's their scientific name. And then these guys as well around the rocks. I like to use these to sit next to rocks. They look cool. There we go. We'll get a couple of these guys around the place as well. Did I? What have I done? Okay, now we're good. The banana things. The banana plants. Yes, I like banana plants. Where the banana plants at? All in there. Some grass as well. Wait, where are my yucca plants? There's like yucca. Yucca. How the hell do you say that? I think yucca? I don't know. Yucca tree. There we go. Chuck a couple of you guys in there. These guys actually get really big as well. See, look how big that is. That's like full on tree size. They actually say yucca tree. Okay, well, makes sense then, doesn't it? And then we will grab some of these little ferns. And then we will use my lovely grass to just fill everything in. There we go. See, because that looks nice, but it doesn't look complete. And the grass just sort of tops it off. I feel like... Because there's different sizes of grass. I have this one, but I have the same type as well, but smaller. I don't know which one I want to use here. I'm thinking the big one for a lot of it. But the smaller one in other places. I don't know where the hell the smaller one is. Is it this one? Yeah, it is. There you go. See, because I can just sort of, like, line the fences with that. And you go down and look at it. It looks kind of cool. Interesting. It is a lot of clipping through the fence there, but it's fine. So I'll do some light edging. There we go. Around here. Are there any other little plants that I can place on the ground as some ground covering near the edge? Just like that, rather than blocking everything off with tall grass, which I've totally just done anyway. It's like these little guys. But I don't really like them. They're just like smaller versions of the shady trees. That's cool though, I think. I like that. There you go. Oh, hang on. been left abandoned in there. That's not at all what I wanted to place. There you go. How about these guys? Oh, they're kind of cool. I like them. They're just sort of like grass bush things. Anyway, there. Enough. Cool. Now, the rest of this can be concrete. Because I want it to be a big, open sort of something. I don't know. There's a certain feel that I want. And I will achieve that feel. I will cop that feel. Sorry. It is the last thing I do. So all this can be concrete. There we go. You can fill all of that okay, well, not all of that shears knit. I'll have to use these guys. Right there. There we go. We'll also let traffic go. Oh, also what I wanted to do is put an Eden project down. Just so we can start to get our land value up. I'm going to do a proper area for this. Actually, it might be cool to put the Eden project in this area here. Just because I'm going to probably clear all that stuff out. Most of all, I just want the Eden project so that we can get like massively high land value and then everything can upgrade so we have all pretty high-rise rather than these sort of uglier small buildings. Which look nice in some places, and I also need to get rid of that because I hate that shopping mall thing. That's ugly. The problem is, like, you go through the gallery, I just keep calling it the gallery, the workshop, and you see stuff and you think, oh, yeah, that'll look really good, but then you get into game and it looks like shit, so it's difficult to know what's going to look good and what's going to look like crap. You don't know until you actually try it and have it in the game. Are you seriously going to... For God's sake. Alright, well. There you go. Be a knobhead then. It's cool. I expect it from you now. Cities. That's the point our relationship's got to. Eh. Beautiful. Alright, I don't know why there's no... Maybe that's not joined up. Because there should be bollards on that as well. Why are there no bollards? Want me bollards? Oh, who gives a shit? Alright, oh! I know what will look good in here, because I need to break this up. I reckon. Where are those flat... These things. See, because if we place... Oh, we could have, like, the path weaving through it. Hang on. See, because if I... Oh, it's too big. Can I get sort of, like... If I go like that, and then, no, hang on, you could move, and then I grab you, and I put you, no, that's too big, and I put you, no, that's not enough space, like that. And then we sort of weave the path through there. Then people can sort of walk in there. You feel? Ja feel? See, because we can sort of... No, I need to make it... no collisions. Can you... Hang on. No. Just... Okay. Okay. There we go. Alright. So then people can walk through that little area. And then if I just decorate this with all me lovely stuff, and also this area. Hang on, I can probably do the same. Over here. Like that. There we go. Hang on, where's me? Where's my rocks? There we go. Get a couple of you guys around. And like that. And like that. Beautiful. And then I can just like fill this in with trees and stuff. Alright, how's that? That looks kind of good. I like it a lot. Little cinematic shot. Also, there's a dog in there. I bet his name's... What do I call that dog? There's a dog that I saw in Cities Skylines when I first started playing it. I can't remember what I named the dog. Was it Keith? Keith the dog. That sounds like something I'd name a dog. There you go. So that little area is done. If I could stop this cinematic shot, that would be just wonderful as well. Thanks very much. There we go. Beautiful. Alrighty. Now we do this area. I wasn't going to do this area, but I'm going to now. So, of course, it's all going to be concrete, because it's got to fit in with the other part. Also, some of you may be thinking, hey, what about the concrete? You know, you place plants on concrete. If I could do, like, little spots around the bottom of them with dirt, I could. But unfortunately, you can't in City Skylines, so I imagine they would have, like, little frames around them with dirt under it, and would just be sort of a thin layer of concrete, so they would still have access to the ground and the dirt and the water and everything. But I can't, unfortunately, do that in City Skylines, so it's just going to have to be a part of your imagination. You'll have to be creative. Let your mind flow free. Or something. Right, so all that's concrete. There we go. And, oh, I have that park. I have that cool park thing. It's like a theater. I mean, it looks like an old Macca's, but it's like a theater or something. That thing. Yeah, Omsk State Musical Theater. A musical theater from Omsk, Russia. Okay. How big are you? Oh my god, are you perfectly... You're perfectly sized. Oh, that's what... Okay. So if we drag that off there, and then... Oh my god, it fits. No, it just... Yeah, oh my god, it fits. Oh my god, something actually worked for me straight away. Oh, that's so cool. Alright, can I get... Oh my god, all those car parks might actually work now. Where's that one that we used over here? Because that's like a really cool car park. I like it. I've gone past it, haven't I? Yeah, I have. Further back down. Oh, that one. That one? No, why don't you... Okay, well. That'll work still, I suppose. Can I put another one there? Now the trees start to clip through there. Sorry, trees. My bad. It doesn't clip through there, does it? No, it's good. So if I put that there, and then... What about these plazas? They could probably work. They would if that didn't clip through there. I could use... Because those are three. If I use just my normal things that I use down on the cliff area to sort of frame the waterline, like these things. It kind of works. I don't know if they really fit, though. No, they don't really fit, do they? What about these things? No, they just sort of look like they're placed there and they're not supposed to be there. So if I... If I just move that out a little bit further and make this turn a little bit sharper. Like this. And then I grab the same plazas. Because I can't remember where the hell anything is. So I have to keep scrolling down through it. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what I have to do. That. There we go. That works. Like that. And then if I just chuck my fence around it. The hell is my fence? Now it's further back down this way. It was probably right next to it, wasn't it? It was. Pretty much. Oh, there we go. Cool. Can I just... No, don't. No. Oh, God, I can't really get under there. Gotta go to... Oh, shit. So there. Eh. And that's not really gonna fit, is it? No, it comes out into the road, so I'll have to use the smaller pieces. Oh, I could just have it just keep running along. Okay, like that. And then if we grab the shorter piece, no, not the gate, the shorter piece. Where the hell is the shorter piece? Oh, here, okay. See, I am just blind. There's so much in the bloody menu to see. I can't even comprehend half the shit anymore. I've been saying shit a lot this episode. It's not even a swear word for me, but some people might not like it, so sorry. Where's me thingy? Yeah, down this way. So far away. Come back to me. Okay, now you clip through that. No, I don't really like that. Damn it. Oh, what can I bloody use? I could use car parks, but I don't have any that are small enough. There's that, but I don't want that. I could use that. That actually wouldn't be out of place there at all. And I do kind of like that. What if I just use my plaza alongside that? How does that work? How do you work? Quite well, actually. And then if I just come into my rocks and I go, whoopsie daisies. Then I go there. Then I can actually, if I just do like this stuff over here, although that's probably a bit like boring. That's the easy way to do it though. I don't want the easy way to do it. It's taken way longer than I thought. I thought because I'd sort of planned the first half of it and actually physically built the first half of it before, I thought it would just be really quick to come through and do it, but it's actually not at all. Oh, where's that spiral car park thing? I don't know where it is. What's that? Oh, that's the dock. Okay. Oh, what about this here? Yes, if I surround that with rocks, will that look, it better look good. Hang on, if I get like a big rock. There's like a couple of small ones. Like that, there we go. I sort of zoned out for a second there. I don't know what I was even thinking of. Throw that in there. Okay, and then like some of the, I don't know why that keeps doing that. Down, down, down. Like that, then some of the other trees, and I just throw in all the other stuff that I've done before because I want to keep it uniform. I don't just want to do a bunch of different styling when it's in the same area. That looks pretty cool. I like that. You can't really see it though. What if I just make all of this concrete like that? That looks pretty cool, doesn't it? I like that. Oh no, I deleted the rocks. God damn it. Don't troll me like that. Jesus. There we go. Yeah. That looks cool. I like it. So, hang on. I don't really like that plaza. Spiral thing I was talking about. Yeah. God. Mine's starting to fall apart. That thing. See, how does that fit there? If I swap those over. And then. That was the least effective way to do that, wasn't it? You idiot, Brayden. And I chuck that. That's probably better that way. Because that doesn't clip through anything. We have the public toilets there. Like that. And then, what can I do over here, though? Oh, there's just so much space to fill in. I could put, like, building. No, I don't really want buildings along there. Car parks. Trees are going to clip through, yeah. Do I have any just, like, flat car parks with no trees or anything? Actually, bushes would be preferable, so there's still some sort of decorations in there. I don't know, I've gone past on me. Oh, what about these guys? If I just place, like, a bunch of these guys there, that would look kind of cool. Actually, if I do that, just at places, like, if I just do it at the ends, that takes up some space. It looks kind of cool. I can do some more of that rock stuff in there. And that just leaves that area to fill in. Which I can probably just chuck one building in there and then do some. Hang on, what about these things now? things I was going to use before. The waterfront, whatchamacallits. No, it doesn't work.
It doesn't work.
What about you? Do I upgrade you? No, you just look stupid. Okay. What if I link that up? Is that useful if I link that up? Okay, it's gonna delete my rock. Why would you do that? There you go. No, I don't really want traffic using that. So I've just deleted my rock for nothing. It's okay, I can get my rock back. My rock will never leave me. Wait, that's not placed correctly. Hang on. Where do you... Okay, there? Yeah, there. Okay, cool. Oh, look, there's a little stoplight there as well. Aw. Cool. Okay, more cutting, which is fun. That person also just merged through a rock and a tree and a fence. Okay, yeah, well, perhaps that's not the best placement of stuff, but it's fine. I mean, they can clearly still walk through it because apparently everybody who lives in this city can teleport and, like, phase shift and stuff. But it's done! All the stuff is done! Oh, no, I got two spiral car parks. I can't have two spiral car parks. What about you? Can you go there? I could totally place you there. I don't know if you fit in there at all, though. With the style, which you don't, so... There you go. Anyway, I'll figure out something to put in there. But that area's pretty much done. That actually looks really good. I'm really happy with it. That looks so good. Let's have a proper look. Okay, let's not click out of the window there. All right. Yee, look at this. We've got a little entrance area. We've got a university. Our subway's through here. We've got some people walking through our rocks and stuff, which I accidentally deleted and were a pain in the ass to put back the way they were. This part's all done now. We've got some more parking. We have a lovely theater thing over here with some more parking and some trees and some decorations. And I haven't actually decorated that properly. Whoopsie-daisies. My bad. That's okay. I'll do that later. All right, cool. That's actually looking really good. That's pretty much all I think we'll do for the episode today. I'm just thinking, the traffic's flowing a lot better now that everything's sort of been moved away from that. Our industry area, I want to do some stuff over here in the time lapse. I want to do some cool stuff. It's a bit sort of bland at the moment. So I want to see about trying to fix this up. I would like some high tech. I basically like to turn this all into high tech. And at some point we will do that. But not yet. Let's just get our lines back up and running. So we make sure that traffic doesn't get too bad. Because if you turn off your public transport, then people start using cars again, and that's not what you want. You want to try and keep as many people out of cars as possible, because the less people that are in cars, it means the less cars that are on the road, which means the less traffic, which means that your city doesn't disintegrate whilst you are looking at it. City loop, metro line, these ones. I want you to be blue. Blue, there we go. You can be the uni line 1, and you can be uni line 2, and you can have lines overview. No, I want to add a vehicle, and I want to, wait, add a vehicle, there we go, cool. They now have 6 vehicles on each line, and that should hopefully start bringing people. But they are totally using the train station to get to the university in the absence of the metro, which is good of them. They're clever, our little Sims, or Kims. I think they're still called Sims, but they're spelt with a C. Totally not ripping off SimCity at all. Oh dear. Anyway, I think that'll just about do it for this episode. So all this stuff's been fixed up in the time-lapse, our entrances to the city. All this looks pretty, which is cool. We have this little area over here. Sorting out our sewage. Nothing, the Eden Project has really done nothing, actually. So, thanks for that, Eden Project. But we'll try and get a special area for that next time. I'm going to make this like a big national park area in here. I think I want to take up like a big amount of space. Probably actually all of this area here. I just want to do like treks and stuff through it. We might do some like hills and put something else in here. I'm not really sure. I want to figure out exactly what I want to do rather than just going and chucking stuff in there, because if you go chucking stuff in, that's not going to look as good. Speaking of not looking as good, this does look as good. That's the worst segue I think I've ever done. But this area looks really nice. There's a little piece of concrete that needs to be placed in there. Come on, come on, come on. Where you at? There you are.
There. Beautiful. So yeah, we now have plenty of capacity for universities, so we'll have some nice, highly educated citizens, so we can start to fill out all this with officers next time. And yeah, stuff's looking pretty good for Vanguard. But if you have any more suggestions, comments, feedback, and stuff, put them in the comment section. I will read them. And if anyone else wants to call me annoying, feel free to do so, because I get a kick out of those comments. Oh dear. Anyway, there you go. Let's actually go and look at this area that we've built so we can finish the episode. There we go. Ah, prettiness. But thank you very much for watching. I will catch you in the next video. And until then, as always, stay awesome. Everybody, everybody.